In section 4.2, we will start with the hydrogen atom, and as we have discussed earlier, that we will take the Coulombic potential of hydrogen atom. As I know that the Coulombic force is 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught and Q1 Q2 over R squared, where Q1 is the charge on proton and Q2 is the charge on electron. And this equation implies by the relation that the potential is minus gradient of F, and this comes out to be the potential between electron and proton is minus 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught E square over R. E being the charge on electron or proton. So we will now go to our radial equation, and our radial equation was minus h bar square over 2m t square u over d r square plus minus, this is the effective potential, so the effective potential I will now put is minus 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught and e square over r plus h bar squared over 2m and l into l plus 1 divided by r squared, and this is u, and this was equal to e times u. By keeping in mind that u was equal to r. So now we will solve this differential equation, and the differential equation is difficult, but we will solve this asymptotically. Now the very first thing that we do here, we want to convert this equation into a cleaner form so that we can apply limits. So the solution of this equation will be asymptotic, as it is very hard to solve this equation directly. So we will go for the asymptotic solution, and for asymptotic solution we will have to convert our equation into a cleaner form where we can put the limits very easily. The other thing that we do here is that we will consider the bound states. Bound states means the electron remains bound to the nucleus or proton. So for bound state, we have already discussed that E will remain negative. So here we will do a supposition that when we will multiply this on this side, then we will have to take that constant is positive. So let's multiply both sides with minus 2m over h bar square. So if I'm multiplying both sides with minus 2m over h bar square, then I will get d square u over d r square, and plus this will come out to be minus 2m over h bar squared and minus e square over 4 pi epsilon naught r plus h bar square over 2m l into l plus 1 by r squared. So minus 2m over h bar square has been multiplied here, and it will be multiplied here as well, minus 2m e over h bar square and u. Now I will have to suppose this is equal to a constant k. K is such that this is minus 2 me over h bar. So when e is negative for bound states, then this k is real and positive. So k is real and positive. So we will now go to our equation again, and here I want to change another variable, but first put this value here. So d square u over d r square minus 2m over h bar square, and to multiply this one with this, so it will become plus in 2m over h bar square, here e square by 4 pi epsilon naught r. Minus and plus minus, and 2m over h bar square cancels with this, and we will have l into l plus 1 over r square, and put u here as well, and this is equal to k square u. Now we will do another supposition, and that supposition is that we will write rho, another variable we define, in terms of r. So rho is kr, where k we have already defined this one. So from here I can write that r is rho over k. Then dr will be equal to d rho over k. And if I simply square this one, squaring both sides, then dr squared is equal to d rho squared by k squared. And I can simplify this one. 2 will cancel with this 2 here. And I will have me squared over 2 pi epsilon naught h bar squared. So put this value here, and we will have this thing equal to d square u divide by, for dr square I will have to put d rho square over k square. D rho square, so k square will come here, and plus this is m e square, and u will come here, m e square u divide by 2 pi epsilon naught, 2 pi epsilon naught h bar squared, 2 pi epsilon naught h bar squared, and put the value of r. R is rho over k. So we are having rho here and k will come here. Plus this one, this term, minus l into l plus 1 by r squared, and r squared from here is rho squared k squared, and u will come as it is, and here we are having k squared u. Now I can cancel the k squared here, so this k squared is cancelled here. If I divide both sides by k squared, then this will cancel, and here we will get k, and this will cancel k squared like this. So I'm having d squared u over t rho squared plus m e squared over 2 pi epsilon naught h bar squared k, and u here minus L into L plus 1 over rho square, and u here is equal to u. Now I will do another supposition, and that supposition is that call this term, which is m e square 2 pi epsilon naught h bar square k, let me call m e square over 2 pi epsilon naught h bar square k, is all this term is a constant term. So we will have to solve, we will have to put this thing, let me define that this is equal to rho naught. So I will have my equation is, I will put this will be rho naught, and here is rho as well. So I will move this to this side. This will come u, and this will come plus L into L plus 1 rho square. This will become rho naught over rho, and u will be common. So my equation will become d square u over d rho square is equal to, I take u is common, then it will come out to be 1 minus. When this will go there, it will become minus, and it will be rho naught over rho, and this will become plus, and L into L plus 1 over rho squared and u. So this is the differential equation which I will have to solve. I haven't done any changes to this equation or towards the solution, because I just converted this form into a much cleaner form, because now rho is directly proportional to r. Whatever condition I wanted to apply on r, I can apply on rho, and it will be right. And as I was unable to solve the equation directly, so I will have to go to the limiting solution of this equation, which we call the asymptotic solution of a given equation. So it is always an approximate solution. Here we will have to keep few things in mind, that the one that we are going is asymptotic solution. So it is always an approximate solution to a given differential equation, not the exact solution of the differential equation. So due to this, we will lose some information about the structure of the hydrogen atom. Another thing that we are missing here is that we are using m here, like the m in this equation, and this m we are using is mass of the electron. This m is actually the mass of electron, which is not right, because here if I see this electron is going around a proton or a nucleus, so their mass will be, in reality this should be a reduced mass, like this is equal to mass of electron and mass of proton divided by mass of electron plus mass of proton. When we will use the reduced mass here, we will get additional information here from this equation. The other limitation that we do to our equation is that we are using sign of R here as we are solving the time-independent Schrödinger wave equation, and this is the radial portion of that equation. Principally, we should have used the time-dependent equation, which is sine RT, where we will use the time coordinate as well. So we will have to take sine in terms of space-time, and this will cause our differential equations, whatever we do here, whether they are in the angular or in the radial equation, we will use only psi r, we will lose information about the spin of electron. So this equation will not give any clue of the spin of electron. Spin can be detected in this equation if we use the time-dependent Schrödinger wave equation, or when we use the psi as a function of space and time, because the electronic spin is not like ordinary particle spin, or for example the spinning object as we are having in classical mechanics. This spin we call a non-physical spin, and we cannot imagine or visualize this, because we can only visualize psi in x, y, z, or we say the space coordinates. It's when in addition time coordinate comes with this, we cannot visualize that thing which will be occurring in space time. So that's the reason that we will use information here, due to the not using the reduced mass here and not using the right wave function here, and also we are solving the equation asymptotically. But even without all these limitations, we will find lots of information about the hydrogen atom or about the atomic structure by solving the Schrödinger wave equation. And let's proceed with this, that what we get on the way. So let's now starting the asymptotic solution of this differential equation. And the differential equation is that d square u over d rho square is equal to 1 minus rho naught over rho plus L into L plus 1, L into L plus 1 by rho squared and u. So the very first that I am determining, that what is the behavior of the differential equation when rho goes to plus infinity, and here I see that what will happen to this equation, and the equation will be, when rho will go to plus infinity, then this will go to zero and this will go much faster to zero. So I will have the differential equation is d square u over d rho square is equal to u. And this is a very simple equation to solve such a differential equation. The solution will be u as a function of rho is equal to a constant e to the power minus rho and plus b another constant e to the power plus rho. Now here I can see that as it is a second order differential equation, so we will have two solutions, and we will have to determine that which of the solution is trivial. So here, when rho goes to plus